The European honeybee might get all the attention, but a true bee connoisseur will point you to the native species. From fuzzy bumblebees to glistening sweat bees and stately longhorns, native bees are wild critters of almost endless variety.
Here we go.
They possess the kind of charm that attracts amateur insect lovers like wasps at a picnic.
Oh, here's a good one.
But these aren't just any biophytes. Led by master gardener Michael O'Loughlin, they're on a statewide mission.
Our effort is to go around and to sample all the bees we can and figure out what species are in Yamhill County, and there are other groups throughout the state that are doing the other counties.
You heard that right. They are trying to survey every bee species in Oregon for the very first time. Experts believe around 500 species might live in the state, but no one actually knows for sure, which is a problem because we could be losing them at an alarming rate.
Over the weekend, dead bumblebees started falling from these trees until eventually shoppers reported it to the various stores.
In 2013, a massive bee kill in Wilsonville, Oregon, made national news. Upwards of 50,000 bumblebees died from exposure to an over-the-counter insecticide called Safari. A novice landscaper had applied it to the blooming linden trees, not knowing the havoc it would wreak. Or as one bee expert told KGW,
I've never seen any sort of a die-off of bumblebees on this scale.
But why was the die-off such a big deal? Well, alongside honeybees, bumblebees and other native bees are essential to the pollination of many of the crops that make up Oregon's $6 billion agricultural industry. So in 2014, the state legislature passed a bill that declared a pollinator emergency.
We became the only state in the whole country that has a funded mandate to put together a strategic health plan for pollinators.
Sara Kincaid is an entomologist with the Oregon Department of Agriculture. To fulfill the mandate, her department teamed up with other state agencies in 2017 to create the Oregon Bee Project. Sara says the Bee Project's mission is to expand our understanding of Oregon's bees, to increase their habitat, and to protect them from pesticide exposure and disease.
Our long-term goal is really to assess whether or not bee species here in Oregon are declining or whether or not they're stable.
To do that, first we need to figure out exactly what species call Oregon home, something the state has never had the resources to do. So the Oregon Bee Project turned to volunteers. Now anyone can sign up with a local team as part of what organizers are calling the Oregon Bee Atlas.
Let's get out there and collect as many bees as possible on as many varieties of plants as we can. Sound like a plan?
Yeah.
All right, have fun.
Today, the Yamhill County team is collecting at the Winters Hill Estate Winery near Dundee.
Here comes a longhorn bee right there.
They spend an hour netting bees, recording the plants they're found on, and preserving just one of each in jars with ether.
This is a bumblebee. I'm not really sure which species, but we'll take it inside in a little bit and work on identifying him.
It's not like catching mammals where, you know, you're a little bit afraid that you don't want to take them out of the population. Insects are, they breed a lot, so there's a huge population.
Next, they head inside the old winery tasting room to start organizing their finds.
I was thinking that, I thought when I caught it, some of these were flies.
So there's your fly right there.
Okay, so those are both sweat bees there.
Yes.
This is where things get complicated. With hundreds of varieties of bees, not to mention all the flies and beetles that have evolved to mimic bees, it's very difficult to tell each species apart.
So at first glance, this bee looks like a bumblebee, but when you look more closely at its face, you can see that it has a clear yellow integument on the face.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so clearly not a bumblebee and kind of hiding out in your box over there.
Oh, yeah. Cool.
Even though they don't know what species many of these specimens are, the endless diversity is a reward in itself.
If you take a look at just the variety that we caught today, it is absolutely mind-boggling, and you start to realize that, wow, all these years that I've been seeing bees, I didn't know there were bees. I thought they would be flies and they were ants, etc., which just makes you wonder, what have I been missing?
While small hives of volunteers survey together in populated counties like Yamhill and Multnomah, out on the Zumwalt Prairie in northeastern Oregon, Sandy DeBono is staying true to most native bee species, which is to say she's flying solo.
They're almost like hummingbirds, they're so large.
I gotta show you this one though. It's a Bombus nevadensis. That's a queen. And see, it's super large.
Sandy is an ecologist at Oregon State University. She's studying both the bees that buzz around the prairie and the ones that prefer nesting in the shade of the neighboring aspen groves.
So we're gonna suspend this nest box up on some tree trunk here with zip ties and leave this the whole season and see which bees come and build nests in here.
The idea is that if the Oregon Bee Atlas can chart where various bee species live and what plants they pollinate, we can better protect and even cultivate them.
Native bees are super important pollinators for both natural systems and agriculture. And so honeybees are having some difficulties. And so the idea is that native bees are becoming more and more important, not only for natural systems, but also for crop pollination.
But collecting the bees is only the first step.
Yeah, those are summer longhorn bees. They're just having a siesta. If it got hot and sunny again, they'd all take off.
It's big, huge antennas.
On a cool July morning, budding bee lovers gather at Oregon State University for the very first Oregon Bee School.
This is three males of the same species.
There are very few experts able to identify native bees with any real detail, so the Oregon Bee Atlas has decided to train its own with week-long courses.
5A, go to 4.
Navigating the identification key is like a choose-your-own-bee adventure book. Granted, one that's written with scientific jargon that may as well be a foreign language.
Equal to half or less than half of the distance separating the lateral ocellus from the inner margin of the eye.
Wow.
It hasn't taken us anywhere yet.
Looking at them through a microscope opens up a whole different world, because you may think that you're looking at, let's just say, a small black bee. Get it under the microscope and you're seeing all sorts of colors, shiny colors, different hair colors, golden hairs and stuff that you would never see just with the naked eye. Especially when you're 56 years old, you definitely would not see them.
Michael jokes that they're all hoping to be the one who discovers a new species.
Yeah, that's great, but it's not going to be named after you, so just don't even ask that question.
In the span of just a few years, a deadly disaster in a shopping center parking lot has blossomed into the dream of finding new life. So the next time you stop to smell the flowers, pause to see what else is there smelling them with you. It might just move the needle of science one bee further.